If you look at South America on the map, you'll probably notice the massive green area covering the northern part of the continent. This patch of green is the largest rainforest on the planet, the Amazon. It occupies most of the 7 million square kilometers of the Amazon basin, which spans from the Atlantic in the east to the tree line in the Andes to the west. If that's not impressive enough, the Amazon forest represents over 50% of the planet's remaining rainforests, comprises of the largest, most biodiverse tract of tropical rainforest in the world, produces more than 20% of the world's oxygen, and is home to the second longest river on the planet. Despite all of its natural attributes, the Amazon forest has been attracting attention in recent years due to another reason. Human intervention is profoundly affecting the balance of the ecosystem, and is doing so on a grand scale. The Amazon forest is ancient. It likely formed during the Eocene era and has been in existence for at least 55 million years. During that time, it went through some radical transformations. Back in its early days, the forest drained into a river flowing to the west, but over the course of millions of years, the drainage basin was split along the middle of the continent by the Porous Arch. As the Andes rose, however, the path to the Pacific was closed, creating a large lake. Within the last 5 to 10 million years, this accumulating water broke through the Porous Arch, joining the easterly flow towards the Atlantic, giving birth to the Amazon as we know today. In addition to the topography of the area, the forest also benefited from the equatorial climate of the region. Look at this weather time lapse. Notice the band of heavy precipitation over the Amazon? This is called the Intertropical Convergence Zone, or ITCZ. In this area, the intense solar energy is hitting the surface, producing a convection zone of rising air that loses its moisture through frequent rainstorms. It is no surprise that rainforests are subject to heavy rainfall. What is perhaps less known is that large rainforests contribute to the formation of rain clouds and generate as much as 75% of their own rain. This self-sustaining rain cycle can be seen from space, as the Amazon jungle is often covered by popcorn-type clouds formed by condensed water vapor released by plants and trees during a sunny day. Despite all the vegetation and abundance of life in the Amazon, the rainforest soil is actually quite depleted. This is because most of the available nutrients are quickly absorbed and stored in the plants themselves. The heavy rain also contributes to this depletion, as some nutrients such as phosphorus are washed away from the soil into rivers, draining away from the forest. Despite that, a balance is maintained, as the Amazon receives a regular supply of nutrients such as phosphorus from an unlikely source. The Bodella Depression in Chad is an ancient lakebed where rock minerals composed of dead microorganisms are loaded with phosphorus. This area is also one of the world's most active sources of dust storms. The dust picked up in those storms on a daily basis is then transported by air currents through the entire Atlantic Ocean, reaching Central and South America. The phosphorus that reaches the Amazon soils from the Saharan dust compensates for what is lost due to the excessive rain and flooding. Given the precipitation levels in the world's largest rainforest, it is not surprising that the area is drained by the world's largest river. Running from the west to the east, at the length of around 6,400 kilometers, it is the second longest river in the world. At an average discharge of about 209,000 cubic meters per second, the Amazon has a greater flow than the next 7 largest independent rivers combined, and represents over 20% of the global river discharge to the ocean. To give you an idea of the magnitude of that volume, you can see the effect of the river on the salinity of the Atlantic Ocean from space. This, of course, is likely due to the fact that the Amazon basin is the largest discharge basin in the world. The Amazon River is only the second longest river in the world, but estimating its length can be quite difficult due to the natural meandering of the river. As you can see, over a period of 30 years, the river course is naturally quite dynamic due to variations in water flow and sediment erosion. Despite its volatility, the Amazon has remained the main transportation route in the jungle since colonial times. The thick vegetation and depleted soil have prevented the spread of agriculture, with most of the Amazon basin remaining largely undeveloped and occupied mostly by indigenous people. Today, the largest city on the Amazon, Manaus, makes up approximately 50% of the population of the largest Brazilian state of Amazonas. Apart from its economic significance, the city is also located near an interesting phenomenon, the confluence of the Rio Negro and the Solimões rivers, which join to create the Amazon River. The merging of the rivers is quite interesting, as they appear to run side by side without mixing for about 6 kilometers. In a way, life within the Amazon is very much like this phenomenon, sustained by a delicate ecosystem balance established over millions of years. It is this balance that is now being threatened by the ever-increasing human activities in the region. To understand why this is happening, you need to note that the Amazon spans through the territory of 9 countries, all of which are developing. As their economies grow, it is only natural for them to try and utilize their untapped resources. A good example for this would be Brazil, whose rapid economic growth over the last decades has resulted in an ever-increasing demand for energy. Given the natural resources of the country, which encompasses most of the Amazon forest, over 65% of the electricity in Brazil is produced by hydroelectric power plants. Despite the fact that hydroelectric energy is renewable, and thus arguably better for the environment than fossil fuel generated energy, there are still serious environmental costs involved in the construction of such power plants. Let's look at the Belo Monte Dam on the Xinju River as an example. First of all, the dam is huge. It is so big that its capacity when fully operational would be more than 11 gigawatts, which would make it the second largest hydroelectric dam in Brazil and the fourth largest in the world. The construction of this facility required that the Xinju River flow is diverted from its natural course, flooding an area of 640 square kilometers, causing damage to fish populations and vegetation, while at the same time increasing the spread of malaria and dengue fever in the region. Finally, the flooded jungle area is likely to produce methane due to the decomposition of plant life, while the energy produced by the power plant is expected to support mining and logging industries, which further damage the ecosystem of the Amazon. Although severe, the effects of hydro plants pale in comparison to the Amazon's most notable ecological threat, deforestation. To give you an idea of the scale of the problem, this is what the forest looked like in 1984, and this is what it looked like in 2016. Deforestation itself is not a new phenomenon, as humans have used the forest for sustenance for hundreds of years. What is new, however, is the pace at which the forest is being cut down. Deforestation rates really picked up in the 1970s, largely driven by the economic growth of the countries in the region and the rise of industrial-scale agriculture. Methods such as slash and burn were incorporated to make the poor soil suitable for agriculture, and following its inevitable nutrient depletion, cattle ranching would take over. In recent years, the returns of cattle ranching have pushed the industry even further into the Amazon, accounting for 80% of the current deforestation rates. Today, the Brazilian Amazon is home to approximately 200 million head of cattle and is the largest exporter in the world, supplying about a quarter of the global market. To put this in other terms, approximately 450,000 square kilometers of deforested Amazon in Brazil now serve as cattle pastures. If this wasn't bad enough already, it is likely that at its current pace, deforestation would destroy the entire Amazon within a century. However, the forest would reach its tipping point far before that and would not be able to produce sufficient rainfall to sustain itself. If the Amazon rainforest were to disappear, in addition to the huge loss of biodiversity, the climate in the region and around the world would experience profound changes. This, however, is a topic for a whole other video. Until then, please consider subscribing, liking, and sharing this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.